Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we discuss the following question, which says a discrete random variable capital X takes values X only from the set N equal to 2, 5, 7, 9. The probability that capital X takes the value X is given by probability of the random variable capital X is equal to lambda into X plus 2 the whole, where this lambda is some constant. In the first part, determine the value of lambda. In the second part, find the mean and variance of capital X. Consider a random variable capital X takes the values x1, x2 and so on up to xn, and they have the probabilities P1, P2 and so on up to Pn. These are the corresponding probabilities of the random variable X taking the values x1, x2 and so on up to xn. Then we have the mean denoted by x bar is equal to summation pi xi, where this I goes from 1 to n, and we have each of these probabilities is greater than or equal to 0, and also summation pi, where I goes from 1 to n, is equal to 1. The next we have the variance of the random variable capital X denoted by sigma square is equal to summation pi into xi minus the mean, which is x bar the whole square, and I takes the values from 1 to n. Now we have sigma square is equal to summation pi into xi minus x bar the whole square, and I takes the values from 1 to n. This could be further written as summation pi into xi square minus 2xi into x bar plus x bar square the whole, and I takes the values from 1 to n. So further we can write this as summation pi into xi square minus 2x bar into summation pi into xi. I takes the value from 1 to n, and here also I take the values from 1 to n, plus x bar square into summation pi, where I take the values from 1 to n. So now we have that this is equal to summation pi into xi square, I take the values from 1 to n, minus 2x bar into, now summation pi into xi, where I take the values from 1 to n is x bar, that is mean itself, plus x bar square into, now summation pi, that is sum of the probabilities is 1. So this is equal to summation pi into xi square, where I take the values from 1 to n, minus x bar square. This is another form of writing the variance. So this could also be written as summation pi into xi square, where I take the values from 1 to n, minus x bar whole square. This is also the variance. This is the key idea that we use in this question. Let's now move on to the solution. In the question, we have that the random variable capital X takes the values X from the set N of numbers 2, 5, 7, 9, and probability of the random variable X equal to X is equal to lambda into X plus 2 the whole, where this lambda is some constant. And the first part, we have to find the value of lambda. In the second part, we have to find the mean and variance of the random variable X. So first of all, we will form a table from the given data. As we are given set n as the set containing the elements 2, 5, 7, 9 and x takes the values from this set only. So x would have values 2, 5, 7, 9. And it's also given to us that probability of the random variable x is equal to lambda into x plus 2 the whole. So when x is equal to 2, probability would be lambda into 2 plus 2, that is 4 lambda. When x is 5, so probability would be lambda into 5 plus 2, that is 7 lambda. When x is 7, probability would be 9 lambda. When x is 9, probability would be 11 lambda. Now let's find the value of lambda. Now we have obtained a table. So now let's find the value of lambda. Now we know that summation of the probabilities of the random variable x taking different values is 1. So here we have summation probability of the random variable capital X is equal to 1. So this means probability of the random variable capital X equal to 2 plus probability of the random variable capital X equal to 5 plus probability of the random variable capital X equal to 7 plus probability of the random variable capital X equal to 9 is equal to 1. So from here we have 4 lambda plus 7 lambda plus 9 lambda plus 11 lambda is equal to 1, that is 31 lambda is equal to 1, and from here we get the value of lambda as 1 upon 31. So this is the answer for the first part of the question. Next we have to find the mean. Now mean is equal to summation pi into xi, where I takes the values from 1 to n. Now in the next part we have the mean denoted by x bar or by mu is equal to summation x into probability of the random variable capital X equal to x, and here x takes the values 2, 5, 7, 9. So this is equal to, when x is 2, we have 2 into probability of the random variable x at 2, which is 4 lambda. So here we have 2 into 4 lambda plus 5 into probability of the random variable x at 5 is 7 lambda. So here we have 5 into 7 lambda plus x is 7. So 7 into probability of the random variable x at 7, which is 9 lambda. So here we have 7 into 9 lambda plus x is 9. So 9 into probability of the random variable x at 9 is 11 lambda. So here we have 9 into 11 lambda. So this is equal to 8 lambda plus 35 lambda plus 63 lambda plus 99 lambda, and this is equal to 205 lambda. Now the value of lambda is 1 upon 31. So putting the value of lambda here, we have 205 into 1 upon 31. So this is equal to 205 upon 31, which is equal to 6.6. So we have x bar, that is the mean, as 6.6. Now we will find out the variance, which is given by sigma square is equal to summation pi xi square, where I goes from 1 to n, minus x bar square. So next we have variance denoted by sigma square is equal to summation x square into probability of the random variable capital X equal to x minus x bar square, and here x takes the values 2, 5, 7 and 9. Now we will prepare this table in which we have the values of x taken as 2, 5, 7 and 9, and the corresponding probabilities are given as 4 lambda is the probability where x is 2, then we have 7 lambda is the probability where x is 5, then 9 lambda is the probability where x is 7, and 11 lambda is the probability where x is 9. Let's now find out xi square, that is 2 square is 4, 5 square is 25, 7 square is 49, 9 square is 81. Next we find out pi into xi square, so that becomes 16 lambda, and here we have 175 lambda, 441 lambda and 891 lambda. Now summation pi xi square is 1523 lambda. So putting these values in this formula, we have that sigma square, which is the variance, is equal to 1523 lambda minus x bar square, that is 6.6 whole square. Now as the value of lambda is 1/31, so here we have 1523 into 1/31 minus 43.56, that is 6.6 whole square is 43.56, and now here we have sigma square is equal to 1523/31 is 49.13 minus 43.56, and this gives us sigma square is equal to 5.57. That is, we have the variance given by sigma square is 5.57. Thus we have got the mean as 6.6 and the variance as 5.57. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.